الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله يا رحمة للعالمين، يا شفيع المذنبين، يا غاية الغمام، يا مصباح الظلام، يا قمر التمام. ألف الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله، يا سيدي يا حبيب الله، يا سيدي يا صاحب الشفاعة العظمى، يا سيدي يا واسطة الوجود والسبب في كل موجود. الصلاة والسلام عليك وعلى آلك وأصحابك أجمعين. اللهم صل على من انشقت الأسرار وانفلقت الأنوار وفيه ارتقت الحقائق وتنزلت علوم آدم فأعجز الخلائق وله تضاءلت الفهوم فلم يدركه منا سابق ولا لاحق. فرياض الملكوت بزهر جماله مونقة، وحياض الجبروت بفيض أنواره متدفقة، ولا شيء إلا هو به منوط، إذ لولا الواسطة لذهب كما قيل الموصوط. صلاة وسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عدد من صلى عليه، وصل على سيدنا محمد عدد من لم يصلي عليه. ماذا سلطان السيد الشيخ عبد الله الفائز الزغساني، ماذا سيد الشيخ محمد ناظم عادل الحقاني. رجال الله أعينونا بعون الله وكونوا عونا لنا بالله عسى نحظى بفضل الله. كيف ترقى رقيك الأنبياء يا سماء مطاولتها سماء. إمام بصيري he's talking addressing prophet says how is it possible that the messengers and prophets can reach your ruqi is your lofty station, your high station, how is it possible? كيف ترقى, he's not asking, he's saying it's impossible. It's impossible that they can reach your high station, Anbiya. And this is Anbiya. Anbiya is first class in creation. They are the top. So if say Imam Bukhari is saying even Anbiya cannot reach, it's impossible for them to reach your Ula, your Ruqi, your ascension, no one can reach. Ya Sama'u Matawalatha Sama'u. صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. لم يساووك في علاك وقد حال سنم منك دونهم وسناء. It's impossible for them to be equals to you in your station. In your, he's saying. Anywhere you've reached is impossible. هو إنما مثل صفاتك للناس كما مثل النجوم الماء. See, this is here. He clarifies what he's trying to say. He said that the example of your, the example between you and the prophets and messengers, that the messengers were only reflecting your trait to people. Every messenger, وكل من رسول الله ملتمس غرفا من البحر أو رشفا من الدم. That every messenger and prophet was taking some of the qualities reflecting of what Allah addressed him. Because he is مجلى الربوية. He is the صاحب, يعني he is the one in which, in whom all the perfection of Allah's manifestations of names and attributes is in him. So every prophet took something from that manifestation. And Imam Busayri is saying, he's saying the example of that is as the water reflects the stars. No, as the water reflects the stars are in the water for, so he's saying for people, the example of messengers and prophets is they were reflecting to people your traits and characters as the water reflects the stars. صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. إنما مثل صفاتك للناس كما مثل النجوم الماء. أنت مصباح كل فضل فما تصدر إلا عن ضوئك الأضواء. الله أكبر. إمام بصيري. إمام بصيري ما شاء الله. أنت مصباح كل فضل. You are the lantern of every favor and goodness. You are the one who dispenses dispenses that light of and favor. أنت مصباح كل فضل فما تصدر إلا عن ضوئك الأضواء. That only from your light, lights, all other lights take their shining. لك ذات العلوم من عالم الغيب ومنها لآدم الأسماء. He's saying that Sayyidina Adam, Allah in Surah Al-Baqarah, he says, وعلم آدم الأسماء كلها. That Allah taught Sayyidina Adam the names of everything. Imam Busayri is saying, Adam was taught the names, but the essence of all these names, those knowledges, you have. And we can go on with what Imam Busayri. Imam Busayri was a sheikh, a muwahid, a alim, a arif, a nur of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's describing here some of the things that Allah opened to his heart about the reality of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the reality of that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why our brothers, they like to label him and accuse him of shirk and kufr and bid'ah and all this, not knowing who that one is. Imam Busayri, when he was writing his famous Burda, he got stuck. And he had chalal, he had half paralysis. He had half paralysis. And he was arif, he was a knower. So he knew which door to knock. So he spent all his time composing these poems in praise of Sayyidina Muhammad. Madih. And one night Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam appeared in a vision to him, and he was stuck. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa anta khayru khalqillahi kullihim. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فمبلغ العلم فيه أنه بشر وأنه خير خلق الله كلهم. So he got here, فمبلغ العلم فيه أنه بشر. He is reciting this verse. The maximum knowledge that يعني our minds, human beings can, okay, he's a human being. Because his appearance is that of a human being. He has the physical appearance of a human being, but nothing like a human being. Which human being can go to Qaba Qawsayn or Adna, past this galaxies, past the... Which human being is able to go with his physical being? Which human being can hear Sarir al-Qalam when the angels are writing on the Lawh al-Mahfuz? Which human beings can see behind him as he see in front of him, see in the darkness as he sees in the light? Which human beings, he spit in the bitter water, it turns sweet. Water, yani endless signs that he is just his appearances, but his reality has nothing to do with what limitations the human beings have. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he said, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to him, and he says, وَأَنَّهُ خَيْرُ خَلْقِ اللَّهِ كُلِّهِمِ. Because Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَنَا سَيِّدُ وَلَدْ آدَمْ. I am the master of the children of Adam. But here, he told Imam Busayri, وَأَنَّهُ, about him speaking, خَيْرُ خَلْقِ اللَّهِ, better than all, every creation. خَيْرُ خَلْقِ اللَّهِ. Anything created, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam exceeds, supersedes any creation. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَأَنَّهُ خَيْرُ خَلْقِ اللَّهِ كُلِّهِمِ. And then he wiped on him and gave him his burda. That's why it's called Qasidatul Burda. Because Prophet gave him his cloak in the vision, in the dream. And Imam Busayri got up And he was better than when he, before he got sick. He got up and there was no problems with him. And went to the masjid and prayed Fajr that day. Sallallahu ala Sayyidina Muhammad. And what did he say? Mudlazamat. Yani the meaning of that verse was, since I committed myself to praising you, وَجَدْتُكَ لِخَلَاصِ خَيْرَ مُلْتَزِمِي. I found you committed to my salvation. I say, since the moment I committed myself to your madih, to your praise, to speaking about your beauty, about your shama'il, about your sifat, I found you committed to my salvation. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So these are the arifin billah. Tonight, alhamdulillah, inshallah, we will do a dhikrullah. And we started with salat ala nabi. We'll end also with our intention is to do a maulid al-nabi, inshallah, and to do salawat on the Prophet. We also want to be saved. That's why we are doing milad. That's why we are doing salat ala nabi. That's why we are praising Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We want to be like Imam Busayri. لازمت أفكاري مدائحه وجدته لخلاص خير ملتزم. Since I committed my thoughts, my being to praising him and honoring him, I found him committed to my salvation. صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه. That's what we want. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he is, they say, I was reading in كتاب الشفاه بتعريف حقوق المصطفى, and he was talking that some of the ulama and some of the a'lam of Ahlul Bayt, they said that أرجى سورة في القرآن, the most surah that gives hope in the Holy Quran is Surah Al-Duha. والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى. It should give us so much more, the most hope in the Holy Quran, because he is Shafi'ul Mudhnibin. He cares for his ummah. He is Ra'ufun Rahim. He is compassionate. He is soft and caring for his ummah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So in this surah is, وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى. Verily, Allah is saying, verily, affirming, Allah will give you until you are pleased. So they said it is arja ayah fil Quran. This ayah is arja ayah fil Quran. Is the verse that gives most hope for us weekend. Why? Because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will never be happy, will never be pleased, knowing that one sinful person from his ummah is entering hellfire. And Allah is saying, وَلَا سَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ. Allah is going to give you until you are pleased. صَلَوَاتُ رَبِّ وَسَلَامُ عَلَى سَيِّدْنَا مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ إمام المرسلين قائد الغر المحجلين مولانا ومولى الثقلين اللهم صل عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. We're not going to make it too long. It's Thursday night. Inshallah, we'll do Khatm al-Khawaj again. مدد يا أولياء الله عينونا بعون الله وكونوا عون الله التوفيق بحرمة الفاتحة.